also, we do have some very special, we have special, but then we have very special people in the band. And at this time, so there's different levels, I guess, but no. The highest level would be what this next person would be. So tonight, we'd like to honor George Holmes. George Holmes is sitting up here at the front. Do you want to come up here, George? Might as well come up now. Been with this band?
Very close to 25.
So almost 25 years with the band, and through this time, he and his lovely wife Jeannie have been part of this band, either conducting, Jeannie has sung. She has been a great introduction for us to some classics, some classical music, as well as beautiful arias from operas, accompanied or conducted by her lovely husband, George. And at this time, George has decided that maybe he'd step back for a little bit and say adieu to us, but he knows that he's always got a perfect spot back there in the trumpet section or right here anytime you want to come up. And so at this time, I'd like to call up Greg to say a few words.
Many years ago, and it's interesting, I'm actually taller than George. Many years ago, I was a high school student, and George was my music teacher at Cameron Heights Collegiate. And there's many, many things one could say about those days, but I would like to talk about the band trips. They went to France, which I wasn't on because I was just a little too young, but I went on the Cuba trip, and I went to, the place in Pennsylvania? I can't remember the name offhand. But I would like to talk a little bit about what the music program was like under George. He basically, it was a training program or an experience program because he didn't put up with a lot of nonsense and he treated us like, not like students, but like musicians that had work to do. And he expected full attendance at rehearsals. He expected punctuality rehearsals, which I'll get back to in a moment. And he also expected good musical performance. If you didn't practice your part, you'd get told. And we played a lot of great music, a good balance of classical music. We played, I remember playing the Schubert's Unfinished Symphony. I remember playing some of the band classics like the Vaughan Williams Folk Song Suite and the whole suite in E-flat, which, you know, probably today they wouldn't do for various reasons. But we did them, and we did them well, and we did a lot of performing. We played, always did the music festivals. It was always emphasized to us that it was very important that we always learn something from it, whether we win or lose. You can always learn something from every band you listen to. That's what George told us. So it's interesting, and there were a lot of light moments, and I don't want to go on too long because I can see the sun going down. But I can remember one time George had given us a lecture. Band rehearsal was Wednesday and Thursday. And he'd given us a lecture about punctuality because people were coming in late. Well, lo and behold, the next day, my dad drove old clunkers and the car ran out of gas because it didn't have the working gas gauge. And I walked in and I said to George, "Before you yell at me, my dad's car ran out of gas." And he just smiled at me. And then when I was recollecting with him later about this, he said, "Well, the best one was this kid who was came in from Breslau area, and he came in one time, and George said to him, 'Why were you late?' He says, 'Oh, the pigs got out.'" So I thought that was pretty good. And the other thing that was really good is George got along very well with the phys ed department. And it's very rarely the music departments and the phys ed department people get on, but I suspect it was because George was probably more athletic than all of the phys ed teachers. He was a sports fan and a sports player, played a lot of hockey and whatever. There's one other incident I will recall is we used to win a lot of the Kiwanis festivals. It was probably the most successful school band program in Waterloo region or county, whatever we called it in those days. And we did quite well at the festivals, but there was one time we didn't do well with the stage band. We went to Toronto. We didn't do badly, but we didn't do as well as we'd like. And the concert was the next week, and you know, George is introducing the stage band. He says, we were just down at the stage band competition in Toronto, and we didn't win, and it's probably a good tribute to my good Salvation Army training. Anyway, I would like to just introduce George here. I don't know if he'll have anything to say, or Mary, or...
Randy
wants to say something. He'll probably amplify a few other things that I missed.
Good evening, everyone. You heard that George is... been a longtime member of the Ayr-Paris Band, and he also had a very long, varied, and accomplished career as both a musician and a conductor. 50 years ago, he was teaching music at Cameron, and he arranged a concert tour to London and Paris for his high school concert band. I didn't attend Cameron School, but George invited me to join the trumpet section for the trip, and I was never sure if that was because of any musical ability or he just wanted a big guy to carry some heavy stuff. I never asked the question, and I'm never going to. Anyway, I jumped at the chance to go, and we had a fabulous trip. The highlight for me, and for all of the band, I think, was a concert that we played in the famous Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. And what a setting for a concert it was. Incredible French Gothic cathedral, flying buttresses, huge circular stained glass windows that flooded the cathedral with beautiful soft light. 800 years of history there, and best of all, incredible acoustics. The cathedral is very large and it has mostly hard surfaces on the inside, and it produces a glorious, rich, kind of immersive sound, lots of reverberation. And when we played, the music seemed to rise and fill the cathedral and resonated in the air long after we finished the last chord. It was a musical miracle to me that the concert happened at all. My understanding is that a band concert in the cathedral was unprecedented. There had been other types of concerts, but never a band concert. How George arranged for his band to get in there and play, I don't know. I'm very grateful to him for doing that, because it was the musical experience of a lifetime. At the time of the trip, which was in the 70s, there was a popular music making the rounds called Jesus Christ Superstar. And we played that music as part of our repertoire in the tour through London and Paris. And tonight, to mark the 50th anniversary of George's conducting on that concert tour, we're going to do some time traveling as George turns the clock back 50 years and once again conducts the music of Jesus Christ Superstar. I hope you enjoy it. Well, thank you, George.
All right.
Okay, George.
As president of the band, I am fortunate to congratulate George on all the years of service he's given to the band. And you can enjoy these with Jeannie, because I know she will. And we want to thank you for all your hard work. And I personally want to thank him for all the fun we have on band trips. Congratulations.
Thank you, my dear.